The .NET SDK command line tools allows us the creation of two types of apps. First one is called as the framework dependent app. That means that the app is dependent upon the .NET framework installed on the host system. While the second one, this one, is called as the framework independent app. Now, this is also known as the self-contained app. In this case, the .NET runtime is bundled along with the exe file. So these two apps actually refer to the final exe file that is released to the public. This is the block diagram of a framework dependent application. So as you can see from here, the yellow box within this dotted line represent the operating system. The operating system can be anything like Windows, Linux, or Mac OS. And our executable is this particular one, my console app, sqlite3.exe. It's the same app that we have created in the previous examples. So we have an sqlite.dll and the system.io.ports.dll, my console app, sqlite3.dll, and all the code that are required for this specific application are bundled together inside this exe file. So this is a framework dependent application. So only the required DLLs are packed inside this one. So when this particular application runs, that is my console app sqlite3.exe runs, it will communicate, it will check whether there is a .NET runtime installed on the computer. Then it will communicate with that .runtime and uses the resources provided by that particular .NET runtime. So for this particular app to work, we need to have a .NET runtime installed on this particular computer. If you are using a Windows system, we need to have a .NET runtime corresponding to Windows system. Same with Linux and Mac OS. So if this .NET runtime is not there, the exe file will not work. That's why it is dependent on the framework. Since only the required DLL files are packaged inside the executable, the size of this particular exe file will be small. And as the we are not packaging the runtime into this one. So when you are distributing these types of files, you have to tell the user that you have to install a .NET runtime to run your application. Now, this is the block diagram of a framework independent application, also known as a self-contained application. This is similar to the previous one. So the yellow box represents the operating system. It can be Windows, Linux, or Mac OS. And we have our executable, that is the My Console app, sqlite3.exe. As you can see that we have the required DLLs, the SQLite DLL and the system.io.ports DLL, as well as the My Console app, sqlite3.dll inside the exe file. Now we also can see that the .NET runtime and the required files are also packaged inside the exe file. So that's why it's called a self-contained application. So the system will not interact with the install runtime since all the required files are inside the exe file. The exe file will work whether any runtime is installed on your host system or not. So you can easily distribute this to a user. So they can easily run it without installing anything. You can just double click on the my console app sqlite3.exe and the system will work. No need to install the runtime. So this is independent of the runtime. Now the major drawback is that it need to have a large size. So the previous one, only the required DLLs were there. So the size was small. Here we are bundling the .NET runtime also with the exe file. So the size will be quite large. So this is one example to show you the size difference. This is a framework dependent .NET app. So the size is around 2.4 MB. While the same app, which is now a self-contained .NET app with the runtime within the exe file. So the size has increased up to 68.2 MB. So you can see that the size actually increases dramatically when we are creating a self-contained .NET app, but it makes it easier for the end users because they don't have to install anything and the system will run. Now we are going to create a framework dependent app and we will be using our old program, My Console app sqlite3. This program would require a .NET runtime installed on our system to work properly. The easiest way to create a framework dependent app is to just use the .NET publish command. So this will create a framework dependent app, but it will also leave the extra DLLs inside the folder. So the app will be inside this particular folder. So this will be inside the publish folder. So you should remember that. So this is our app and the size is around 140 kilobytes. Since we have a lot of dependencies, you can see the associated DLLs also here and the runtimes and other stuff. Now, if you send this folder, the application will work as long as the .NET platform is installed on that particular system. Now you can change it to a single file also. For that, you can go to the, you can change the command from here. So I will be using this particular command, .NET publish minus b publish single file equal to true. And I will also include this particular option, minus p include native libraries for self-extract equal to true. So that is to make sure that all the DLLs are inside the exe file. If it is a simple project with minimal dependencies, you don't require this one. So here we are having dependencies of our SQLite library as well as the system.io.ports library. We have to use this one. So we can create a single exe file. Now the one that is going to tell the compiler that we have to create a self-contained or a framework dependent file is this option, that is the minus p self-contained equal to false. So this is self-contained equal to false. That means that we are going to create the framework dependent exe file. So you can copy the entire command from here. So this is the command I'm going to give. Now the code will be in this folder, bin release net 8.0, and it will be inside win-x64. Then inside that there is one folder called as the publish. That is the one we will get our. So this is our single file framework dependent app. So this has created a db. I mean, we have not written anything, so the size will be 0 KB. And you can see that the size of this particular exe file is 2 MB because it is a framework dependent app. So you are not including the runtime with this one. Now you can see that there is a long list of directories to get to your particular publish file. So you can change it by using the minus O option. If you send it to another computer that does not have a .NET framework installed, this will not work. Now we will create one that is framework independent. So for that one also, we will be using our old one, my console app SQLite 3 project. So first thing we'll do is we'll go here. We'll use the same command, but here self-contained equal to false, you have to write it as self-contained equal to true because we are creating a self-contained application. I will also create a new folder and I'll call it as self-contained because we do not want to navigate the whole thing again. So I'll call it as self-contained. So this is the only change you have to make it, and you can press enter. Now here we can see that the self-contained exe file has been created and it is inside the self-contained directory. Now we'll go inside the self-contained directory, and here is our exe file. So you can see from here that the size is around 67.9 megabytes. So that's because the runtime is packaged with this particular exe file. Now if you send this exe file to another computer that does not have a .NET runtime installed, the system will work because the runtime is already bundled with the exe file. Here I would like you to introduce to our website. This is our website name, xanthium.in. I will put the link in the description. As you can see from here, we provide tutorials on various embedded systems like Arduino, ATmega328P, Microchip, and different ways to interface these particular microcontrollers to the PC. We also provide tutorials on languages like Python, .NET, like C#, Visual Basic .NET, etc. So you can check our website for these kinds of tutorials. We also manufacture embedded system products like the USB to CC converter that you can see from here, both the isolated one and the non-isolated one. Now we also have a companion website to this particular video. So the link to that particular website will be in the descriptions. So do check it out. So do check our stores also and our products like this one. This is in a completely isolated USB to serial converter. So this is the USB section and this is the RS-232 and the RS-485 converter. The whole section is completely isolated using both digital and power planes. So nothing, whatever happens wrong here will not be transmitted to your PC. So this thing is ideal for interfacing with different legacy USB to serial RS-232 devices or RS-485 devices. This is the device I was talking about. As you can see, the ground is completely isolated from here. And you have an isolated RS-232 port as well as an isolated RS-485 port. This is a DB9 port. We also have a screw terminal for RS-232. So if you don't need any isolated USB to serial converter, we also make a simple USB to serial converter. This one. Here we have this is non-isolated, but it has RS-485 port as well as the RS-232 port. Similar to the previous one, but non-isolated. So do check it out. If you want it, you can buy it from our store.